My name is Maram Hijazi and I'm 16 years old almost and I live in Nova Shalom.
After school, walking home, fresh dirt under my fingernails and I can smell hot asphalt, car screech to a halt to let me pass. And I cannot remember what life was like through photographs.
Big brother were born in Jerusalem and we were living there. We just moved there from the north in Tamra, where my parents are originally from, and Neve Shalom was still a new and little village, so they were still asking people to come and live here, and they heard about my parents and they were interested in them, and they asked them if they would like to move here.
My name is Omer Schuster from Neve Shalom. I'm 14 years old. I'm in Neve Shalom for 11 years. And my favorite singer is Eminem. And my favorite team is Hapoel Jerusalem. And I'm working as a DJ. My parents, they wanted to do something special that will help or something, so they came here. We came here from Tel Aviv. I born in Tel Aviv until the age 2 or 3, and then we came here.
Neve Shalom Wat Al Salam si trova più o meno a metà strada tra Tel Aviv e Gerusalemme. La collina sulla quale il villaggio è costruito fu donata dal monastero di Latrun. Il villaggio fu un'idea del prete Bruno Ussar, che voleva creare una comunità dove palestinesi ed ebrei potessero vivere insieme.
At first they were looking for new families to come and live here. But now, since there are like so many people that are applying to live here, so now we start choosing people. Like all of the grown-ups that live here, they do meetings and decide which families they would like to come live here.
It's good to live in Neve Shalom because everything is different. I was grew up in Tel Aviv, for example, I would think different. I have lots of friends, Arab and Jewish. It doesn't matter. There is no difference at all. It's the same.
יו, זה הפינאלי, סבלימינלי, ריקלי, נתקע לי. נכנסתי למשחק, למה המשחק אוניברסל, לא נורמלי, זה בא לי, היפ-הופ אורגנל. אוכל את כל המתחרים, תקרא לי קניבל. כל מה שצריך זה פטיפון, מיקרופון.
I know that there's a lot of places in Israel where different cultures live, Jewish and Arab, Islam and Christian, but it's not the same. Because here we grew up together, we're the same. We can't even tell what kind of culture you are. Because we're so used to it, they're forced to live together, and here it's by choice.
I fratelli Nere, Ori, Sonnenschein sono ebrei come Omer. Ori ha 21 anni e Ner ne ha 25. Ner è stato il primo bambino a nascere nel villaggio.
A lot of things that came very naturally to us, like, you know, that we had like very good friends who were Arabs, or that many of these things are, or like a lot of preconceptions and misconceptions people have about the Arabs, especially in the Jewish society, we didn't really have them because we knew the people firsthand.
Most people don't know any Arabs, they never met Arabs. The only thing they know about Arabs is what they hear on the news or from other people or whatever. So they can never actually meet them face to face.
So you come to see that it's different in the way you grasp things and that how things look to you. Your perspective on things is very different, but you don't come to realize this until much later.
A lot of people, when I meet outside of the village and I tell them about the village, there's a series of questions that always, it comes naturally to people. Like, wait, you live with Arabs? Wait, you have Arab friends? You go out with Arabs? And then they ask, and when there's a suicide bombing, I mean, is it a dangerous place to be in? Has there been rioting? Even some people ask me in the village and things like that.
People outside the village, they find it hard to understand their relationships that we have with the Jewish neighbors. It's weird to them, but they don't understand that to us, they're like, we're the same. They can notice that they're different from them, and they treat them, they might not talk to them as much as we talk to them, because we are different, they're Jewish, I'm an Arab, but still, it's not like that. It's really hard to explain unless you live here and you're used to them.
I had a girlfriend from Neve Shalom, that she's half Arab, half Jewish. But I don't care if I love some Arab girl. I don't care. If I love her, it doesn't matter.
If one of my friends says I want to go out with a Christian boy or a Jewish boy, I say go for it. If you like him, then why not? But for me, I just love my religion so much, and I would really like it if the person that I go out with would be Islamic and would pray. I would love that. That's just me. But I have friends that have gone out with boys or girls from different cultures. That happens a lot, and it's very common, like here where I live. And yes, why not? מול הפרצוף צלצלה בתוכה ערימה עם סבלנות בלי אלוהים את הכל עוד מתחננה
Pretty amazing. I mean, you explain about the village and it's, oh, but you know, it's a village with good Arabs, with nice Arabs. But now even when I grow up, it's the same thing. I mean, they talk about my village and they say, but they're all Christians, right? Or but they're all intellectuals, right? Or they're all basically saying they're all good Arabs, right? They're not the picture we have in our head. That's the majority, not what you have in this special place. These are special kinds of Arabs, not the real Arabs we know.
Ranin Bulos e Noam Schuster sono amiche del cuore. Noam è la sorella maggiore di Omer, il DJ, ha 18 anni ed è ebrea. Ranin, invece, ha 20 anni ed è araba. Sono cresciute insieme e ognuna considera casa dell'altra come casa sua.
We are in the house of my aunt. She lives in the village too. And I'm watching some of the village kids. The idea of the village is not like you come here and you forget who you are, and it's the opposite. It's you know who you are. You have your own culture, your own identity, but you're living with people who has different identity and different culture, but you still want to live with them. I mean, and you want to study their culture, and this is the idea of the village.
Ranin is Arab and I'm Jewish. I mean, it sounds stupid, but I think this is one of the things that is really, really, really keeping us really together, because we know how to appreciate each other, one another, and like really understand what friendship is about.
I mean, we are friends. We're like, I mean, forget that we're Jewish and Arab. Yes. I mean, we're human beings. We have we argue sometimes,
and
we get upset from each other.
The
like
village too, we have problems in the village that every village has.
And every, especially small communities, because it's a small community, everybody knows everybody, so it's much easier to have problems than in a... But the problems are not based on racism or politics, or just problems between human beings.
Il villaggio ha delle scuole per diverse età, dai bambini piccoli fino ai ragazzi di 14 anni. Poiché ci sono solo 50 famiglie che vivono nel villaggio, la maggior parte degli studenti viene da fuori, sia dai paesi limitrofi che dalle grandi città, come Tel Aviv e Gerusalemme.
يا بنت الحلال لما تشوف وجهي بتعرف الجمال لما تسمع عني طوال رح تنجني صدقين الكل بحن الكل شناني زي الفل وببلغش بحكي على حالي امسي مش موالي فكرش على حال فك كمان عليك لو انت انا لما تسمعني مش رح تقول اسكت ولا سد ما تعديت علي بكون ببدا هد عشان امسي جديد مع كلمات الحديد اندورت علي بقول لك وين انا سمعت كمان حبيتهم بقول لك صحة وهنا
My name is Omar Abdel Kader and I live in Jerusalem. I came here before 3 years and I learn here. There's a people that think that I'm crazy because I came here, but there's a people that think it was good choice. I think it's the best thing that I did in my life to come here.
Le scuole sono rigorosamente bilingue e tutti gli studenti devono imparare sia l'ebraico che l'arabo. A Neve Shalom Wat Al Salam non ci sono le scuole superiori, quindi i ragazzi più grandi devono frequentare le scuole fuori dal villaggio. Queste scuole non sono più miste, sono ebraiche o arabe.
Here in school, I mean, we were used to all the time, like when you have your notebook or whatever, you write your name in Arabic, and in every sentence you write it in Hebrew and in Arabic. And when I went to another school outside the village, I remember doing my notebooks, writing in the two languages, and I remember like everybody kept like laughed at me because nobody did it, only me. So it's something that you grew up on, and I think it's very special.
Sono molti gli arabi che vivono in Israele. Questi arabi sono cittadini israeliani, ma si considerano palestinesi. Anche a Neve Shalom Wat Al Salam, il problema dell'identità palestinese è molto sentito.
You know, for me it's this is Palestine. I mean, I'm a Palestinian. This is my land. This is my home. It's of course like hurting for me to see how Palestine is vanished and how it's not a Palestinian country anymore. I mean, it's not like I have a really a big gap with generation. It's not like my grandfather was Palestinian, and I don't. I mean, my grandfather, the father of my mother, he was born in Palestine. He grew up and he was a Palestinian.
Hard to explain. I mean, I consider myself a Palestinian, not an Israeli citizen. So it's because I am a Palestinian, and I hate seeing the things that happen to them, and they're my people, so, and they should be respected and they should be independent. I still feel for them, and it's hard for me to see them, and it really hurts me when I see someone hurt them. But then again, I'm not for suicide bombings. I still think it's a horrible thing to do, and they should stop it, because that's not the way to solve anything.
Basically, when it comes to suicide bombing, I don't feel anything about anti-Palestinian. I feel like I don't like the terrorist groups. I don't like people. I don't like the method they chose to resist the situation, to change the situation. I think it's a bad choice, especially for us and for them, but doesn't make me think any less of the Palestinian people or Arabs in general. Just like I don't think the Arabs should feel different because we have extremists or what our soldiers do. It doesn't mean that Jewish people in general, it's just another one of those preconceptions and prejudices and all that stuff. There is mandatory military service in Israel right now. Unfortunately, our military not only is mandatory, but is doing things that are difficult to agree with many times, and they do things that I can't agree with at all. But I don't disagree with the idea of, of there is some duty you have to do to your country, and you have to, like income tax or things that you have to do when you're a citizen in Israel.
There is a part of me that understands them, because in Israel it's very difficult not to go to the army. They will look at you in a very strange way. Yeah, you won't take the full rights that a soldier would take if he goes to the army. They will treat you as like you're different, or like you're a betrayer. Yeah, in the village, some choose to go, some choose not to go. I have friends that went, but Nam is my closest friend. And I have another friend, she's close to me too, Naomi, and they both refused to go to the army. And for me, it was very normal and natural. I knew it from the beginning that it's just, we even never talked about it, because I just knew it.
I mean, for me, turning 18 and walking here in uniform after 18 that I grew up here, it's like betraying everything that I grew up on. I mean, I've been living in Ranin's house since I remember myself. I mean, and that was my argument also in my trial, in my army trial. Ranin is very right, because it's very, very, very hard to do it, because all my friends now are in the army.
I talked to some of the people here about it, and they would rather if I didn't go to the army, if I found a way out of it. And they know that I go. They know that I didn't do what I could to get out of the army altogether, and they disagree with my decision. We have different points of view, and they don't like what I'm doing, but that's not really hurting our personal relationship or anything. And they know even in the mornings I have to get to where I have to get to in the military. I have some kind of just desk job somewhere. I have to get there every day, so I need a lift from the village to the bus station, and whoever comes, if it's one of the Jews or the Palestinians in the village, and they give me a lift. I've never been refused a lift because I was in uniform or anything like that. I mean, I'm not gonna strut around in the village in my uniform. I'm not gonna, when I get home, I take it off, because I know it. You know, some people don't like the fact that I'm in the military.
È vero che l'esempio di Neve Shalom Wat Al Salam è una realtà molto limitata. ma anche nel suo piccolo è la prova di come due popoli possano vivere insieme, cercando di affrontare i loro problemi senza violenza, con tolleranza e con un grande rispetto l'uno dell'altro.
To me, peace is just treating people as humans and nothing else. I mean, not doesn't matter what culture. People shouldn't even look at that. I mean, that's what I think. They could look at it in terms of respecting each other and the way people live, but peace to me is just treating people the way humans need to be treated.
I think peace is going to happen through some sort of creative agreement, through acceptance, through education, through leadership, but it's going to come. It's just a matter of time. And coexistence works. I mean, the two peoples are in this land of Israel, Palestine, and they're going to find a way to coexist. It's going to finally happen sometime. Just, we're waiting.